Mission sequence start. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Hello, friends. My name's Alyssa, and I'm the Science Program Manager at Boston Children's Museum. And today, I'm going to show you how to make and launch your own Stomp rockets.
I feel the liftoff. The clock has started. Roger.
I've done this a zillion times. It's really fun. And if you do it right, the rockets will go really far. So, let's get started. Let's start with the launcher. The things that you'll need to make the launcher are 2 or 3 feet of PVC pipe with a 1/2 inch inside diameter, 2 or 3 feet of tubing with a 1/2 inch diameter, and a 2-liter soda bottle. And then you're going to just attach them all together any way you can. You can jam the tubing inside the bottle and connect the tubing to the pipe. Use duct tape, use whatever you gotta do. One good thing to know about this kind of tubing is if you heat it up using a hairdryer, it gets really soft and pliable, and then it's easier to kind of squish into things or stretch out or do whatever you need to do with it. So this is your launcher. And you can get these parts from your local hardware store. They're not hard to find. And most stores will even cut things down to size for you, so you don't have to worry about having some kind of special tool to do that. Okay, that's your launcher. We'll put that aside. We're going to need that later. Now, to make your rocket, you'll need a few things, and you probably have a lot of them in your house already. First, construction paper. Whatever color, whatever you want, doesn't matter. You'll need index cards or some other kind of cardstock or heavy paper. Again, old greeting cards work well for this, but you know, whatever you have, but you do want it to be pretty stiff. You'll need scissors and tape. Whatever kind of tape you got. I have a few different kinds of tape here. The colorful tape is fun because you can kind of use it to decorate the rockets as well. But this is what you'll need to get going. So to make your rocket, what you'll be doing is answering a series of questions about it. And the first question is, how do you want the body of the rocket to be? Do you want it to be tall this way? Do you want it to be shorter this way? Do you want to cut your piece of paper down and make it even shorter? That is up to you. Once you've decided which way the body of the rocket's going to go, you want to roll it around the PVC pipe. Now, you don't want to roll it super, super tight. You want it to be able to slide off the PVC pipe pretty easily. So that's pretty good. You don't want it to be super loose like that. You want it to be snug, but it should still slide out pretty easily. Then tape it closed. Perfect. Then you need to close off the end of your rocket. And you want to do that because remember, the rocket is powered by you stomping on the soda bottle and forcing all the air out of the soda bottle and through your rocket. And if the end isn't closed, the air will just whoosh right through and not send the rocket anyway. You want it to get trapped inside the rocket and then push it off the launcher. So close it up. Now you want to decide if you want it to have a cone or not. And if you do, how big should that cone be? Now I'm going to give my rocket a cone, and I'm going to make it green. Making the cone can be a little tricky. To do it, just sort of roll a cone shape around one point on the paper. Definitely takes some practice. Now, I could make this whole thing the cone, and it would be enormous. I could cut it off really short and make a tiny little cone. I think I'm going to make mine like that. Yep, that's pretty good. Okay. Next big decision. Fins or no fins? And if you do want fins, how many? And what shape do you want them? You can have one fin, you can have four fins, you can have 27 fins. And you can make them triangles or rectangles or octagons or, I don't know, whatever you like. I'm going to make three fins, and I'm going to make them a triangle shape. Okay, there's my rocket. Oh, wait! It needs one more thing. It needs a name. Rockets always have names. I'm going to name mine after the museum snake who's living in my house right now. His name is Oliver. So I'm going to call this the Oliver. There. Now, if you want to, you can get out your crayons and markers and other crafty things and decorate your rocket a little more. You can use colorful tape to decorate it, whatever you want. I think I'm pretty happy with how mine is right now. And besides, I'm excited to get outside and launch it.
Discovery Roger, go for deploy.
All right, friends, here we are. It is time to launch the rocket. I have my friend Jack here with me. He's going to help me out. And I have the Oliver ready to go. So, are you ready, Jack?
Yeah?
All right. I think let's get ourselves set up, and we're going to launch this rocket.
Yeah.
All right, Jack, I'm going to aim it kind of that way.
Okay.
And I'm going to count to three.
Okay.
So I'm going to count down from three. When I do, I want you to stomp on this like it is the nastiest, most disgusting bug you have ever seen in your whole life.
I like bugs.
Okay. What don't you like?
Kale.
Stomp on it like it's a piece of kale and you are just going to drive it into the ground and there will never be kale anymore.
Okay.
All right. Ready?
Yeah.
3, 2, 1. Woo!
No. 3, 2, 1.
Jack, whenever you're ready, I'm going to count backwards from three, and I want you to stomp on it as hard as you possibly can.
I'm ready.
Okay, ready. 3, 2, 1. Woohoo! Nice job! Long distance high five! Okay, friends, I hope you try making your own stomp rockets at home, and if you do, please send us a video and let us know how it went. Don't forget to keep checking back here on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube for more cool stuff that you can try at home. Thanks for joining me, Jack, thank you, and we'll see you again soon. Wait a second, don't go anywhere, I forgot something. We have big news to share. If you're a fan of STEAM activities like this one, and also hands-on demonstrations, workshops, performances, you are going to love our Created by eFestival. The festival is a week-long virtual event that will get you and your whole family inspired to create, along with artists, technologists, makers, and all kinds of really cool people. It's coming up October 19th through 24th, and you can register for free in the link below. Mark your calendars, you are not going to want to miss this one.